Hello everyone, what's up? In this Photoshop tutorial, I want to talk about gradient maps and how you can use them to apply some lovely color grading to your photos. Maybe I'm a little late to the party, but I just recently stumbled upon this method in the post-processing subreddit. So check out the link in the description if you want to see some other examples of this method. So let's get started. First off, you can find the gradient map layer under the adjustment layer menu right there. Here you can see gradient map, so let's apply it like that. The basic gradient uses the colors you have set as your foreground and background color. That means in this case we get a simple black to white gradient, which will turn our image into a black and white image. So in order to color grade our image, after applying the adjustment layer, we want to switch the blending mode to one of the blending modes in this section. Depending on which you choose, the effect of it will be stronger or weaker, of course. I personally prefer the overlay blending mode because besides changing the colors a little bit, this will also add some contrast, as you can see right away. Of course, to not make it look weird, let's also drop the opacity. I usually aim for around 30%. That should be enough. So we still haven't changed the colors. Our gradient goes from black to white. And if you think about it, it kind of functions like split toning in Lightroom or the Camera Raw editor. On the left side, we do have our dark pixel, while on the right side, we do have our bright pixel. That means right now, the darkest pixel will be affected by the black color tone, while the brightest pixel, for example in the sky, will be affected by the white color tone. Because of that, and because we don't use any color in here, just black and white, with this gradient map, we just add some more contrast to this image. Of course, I want to color grade this photo, so let's change that. Let's say I want to apply a cold color tone to the shadows. So let's go with something like this and now carefully turn up the color. And you can immediately see some changes in the image. Let's see, I think this is a pretty good color tone. With this, we basically have color graded our shadows. Now let's do the same for the highlights. And since this is an image that was shot during sunset, I want to have some nice warm color tones in here. So of course I'm going into this color range right there. And let's just boost the saturation all the way up so we can see the effect. Maybe we want some more orange tones. Okay, now you can see we basically have applied some split toning. The cool thing is this not only changed the colors but also added a little contrast, which works really, really good. But of course, there's more to this gradient map. Let's open it up once more. Right now, we do have our shadows and our highlights. When you're clicking on one of those points down here, you can spot a new dot in the center of this line. So let's say I want this image to be on the warmer side. So I can simply drag this to the left side. By doing this, less and less of the dark tones will be affected by the blue color tone. So by simply using this point, you can precisely color grade the image as you want it. You could also make the highlights a little less warm by dragging the point to the right and just make the midtones colder this way. Or we could simply add a third color tone by clicking right next to it and this way getting a new color tone. Of course, you can adjust the color as well. So let's say we want to have some more red tones in here. Just like that. We can still adjust the shadows to our liking. So in this case, I want more of the dark tones to have this blue color cast. So let's drag this point up. All right, so here you can see we went from a rather boring shot to a nicely color graded image. By the way, if you like the gradient you just created, you can of course also save it for future images. Pick up a name like sunset gradient and hit the new button. And there it is. All right. Of course, this not only works for sunsets, but for a wide range of images. So here we have a forest image and applying warm color tones like in the before image wouldn't make much sense. So First off, let's apply the gradient map. Then let's change the blending mode to overlay again. And let's also bring down the opacity. Since we have a black and white gradient, we have now just added some contrast. So let's change the color tones. Instead of black shadows, I think I want to have some blue shadows in here as well. So something like this. Looks good to me, it fits the forest theme. So let's hit OK. And instead for warm highlights, I want to give this more of a forest feeling by applying a green color tone to them. In this case, we need to be careful with the saturation. That means the farther you are on the right side of this color palette, the more saturated the color will be. So I try to aim for the center here. Maybe make it a little brighter. Just like that. Okay. And again, you can see we have added contrast and also we changed the colors quite a bit using only a gradient map adjustment layer. Let's try to bring in some twilight colors to this image. Let's create a gradient map, change the blending mode to overlay, drop the layer opacity, and let's work on the color tones. Again, since this just works pretty well, I'm going to apply a blue dark color tone to the shadows. You will notice this will also make the dark parts of the sky darker. That should look good. And for the bright highlights, let's see. I think somewhere in this range does look pretty nice. Okay, now let's add a third point. And here I want to have some more red tones. This really starts to look like a twilight shot. Now I think the foreground might be a bit too much, so I want to drag this middle color to the right some more. And also this point right there. So we just get more blue tones overall. Okay, let's see. This is much better. Then finally, let's check it out on another forest image. Create the gradient map, change the blending mode. Actually, let's just go with soft light this time. And let's also drop the opacity. And let's start with the highlights for this one. Here, since we are in the forest again, I want to have strong green highlights. Go with a very saturated color even. I think that looks good. For the shadows, let's see. Green doesn't look that good. I want to have some color contrast, so I'm going with a cold color tone again. But I don't need that much saturation. So something like this looks really good. Okay. And you can see we have a lot more contrast and the color tones are way more balanced throughout the image. So I hope this method will help some of you. Of course, if you have any questions about this process, let me know in the comments. And thank you so much for watching this video.